Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to The Edit Place, and today we are talking about DaVinci Resolve for iPad. What a shock. Depending on when you're seeing this video, it's coming out very soon or it's already out, and I want to help you get the best experience possible with it. Blackmagic has already released the fact that it is most optimized for M2 devices. This is an M1 iPad Pro, but any iPad running iOS 16 will have limited functionality. At the time of this recording, we don't know what that limited functionality is, but I can take a couple guesses. So no matter the processor inside of your iPad, I want to help you get the smoothest playback experience possible with a couple different tips. So maybe you have a clip like this and you can see it's kind of stuttery. It's not too bad, but it's definitely not playing back in real time. Now, the reason that this clip is specifically not playing back very quickly is because I added noise reduction, which is definitely one of the heaviest processor and graphics effects that you can put on any video clip. If you don't need to see those changes and you're just trying to make cuts and move clips around very quickly and seeing the final color grade and noise reduction doesn't really matter, your easiest and fastest method is going to be this little rainbow circle star icon up here towards the top left. That is immediately going to turn off all effects for the entire timeline. It doesn't get rid of them, it just temporarily turns them off. So now when I hit play, we can see a playback really smooth and I don't have any issues. I can scrub around to the entire timeline very, very quickly. But then if I just hit it again, all my effects turn back on. And now I can export the video with all my effects and things like that. If it is imperative for you to keep your color grade, noise reduction, whatever effects turned on, because turning off effects sometimes turns off things like titles or other things necessary that you want to view, your next bet is going to be changing the timeline resolution. Now, the cut page has a nifty little feature that allows you to change aspect ratios and resolution very quickly. It's actually right next to the button we just talked about. So if you click this up here, we can see that defaults to a 1080p timeline. I can go ultra HD, which with this footage is going to make it stutter even more. And this is 6K footage, so it's having a tough time. So maybe you started out with 4K, going down to 1080p is going to help it play back even smoother. But if you need to go more custom than this, you can go into your timeline settings and even go further, and you can go, is it 1920 still by 720? I mean, use 720 in so long, I forgot what the vertical axis is. So I could go to 720. What is the, that's gonna bug me now. Really forgot what 720p is. 1280 by 720. 1280 by 720. There we go. That's looking a little bit more normal. And so now we can see that we're pretty much getting, yeah, very smooth playback with all of that turned on. And again, right before we go to export, we can easily change this back to, you know, Ultra HD if we want to output a 4K timeline. We don't need to play it back anymore. We can just go in and export it. Those same master timeline settings are also accessible through the settings icon in the bottom right hand corner. Under master settings, you have your timeline resolution right hither. So one more tip for improving playback is, let's say you're in a similar situation where you need to keep your effects turned on, your color grades, titles, things like that. Changing your timeline resolution doesn't seem to be helping, or maybe you have to keep it at a certain resolution for whatever reason. Your best bet is going to be going in and temporarily turning off the effect that is causing the problems. Having a color grade isn't the one causing problems right here. So if I go to this clip, we can see all of our nodes right here. And the problem node is the noise reduction on this first node here. So I can click on the node number and it's going to turn that off. So my color grade stays, but now when I press play, I'm getting that very nice smooth playback because the noise reduction was the only issue, not the LUTs and all the exposure changes and stuff. Now, this can be annoying because obviously you kind of have to go around it individually and turn off like the first node or wherever you have the effect. And if you have different effects like aperture diffraction, halation, there's a lot of open VFX or open effects plugins that take a lot of power. And so turning those off individually while still keeping the Rec 709 conversion LUT or just stylistic LUT turned on is a good option if you have to go down that route. Just don't forget to go back and turn on the nodes because it's kind of easy on a small screen to be like, oh yeah, noise reduction's on, that's fine. And then export it, realize that noise reduction wasn't on it, and that's not very fun. So it's the least convenient tip, But if you need kind of the best of all worlds, it is an option. And if you're new to Nodes and Resolve, learning what you can do with Nodes is super important. And if you want to see a whole video on the different types of Nodes there are, let me know down in the comments below, because I'd love to keep talking about DaVinci Resolve. A ton of people are going to be adopting it, especially on the iPad. And so I want to make content that you guys want to see. So let me know down below. Make sure you get subscribed so you don't miss out, and check out the whole playlist of DaVinci Resolve for iPad over here somewhere. You know how YouTube works. See you guys in the next video.